is a proud moment to the state when country's economic survey 2020 to 2021 that was presented to parliament declared that Telangana state was one of the few states that could recover economically faster from the financial crisis created by the COVID-19 pandemic. All the frontline workers toiled courageously and momentously in saving the state from coronavirus. Today, the state is safe due to the tireless and continuous services rendered by the medical and police personnel as well as the sanitation workers. I convey my hearty compliments to all those. Corona vaccination. The coronavirus created doldrums in the entire world. My government had adopted effective steps to prevent the spread of dreaded coronavirus by providing free medical treatment to the corona affected. It saved precious lives of many. The entire country recorded 1.4% average deaths due to corona, while the state it is 0.54%. The percent of the people who recovered from corona all over the country is 97.2, and it is 98.88% in Telangana state, which is more than the country's percentage. Country's economic survey report stated that the Telangana state stood top most in the country as far as curtailing the spread of corona pandemic. Deaths due to the virus, fast economic recovery from the pandemic, and for conducting a greater number of tests. As on date, the corona vaccination program is being conducted successfully on priority basis. The entire medical fraternity and the frontline workers have been successfully vaccinated. At present, vaccination program is in progress for those who cross 60 years of age and also those suffering from comorbidities. Aiming at vaccinating 50 lakh individuals, the government had made necessary arrangements, which included organizing 1,200 vaccination centers, innovations that the new Telangana state achieved. Telangana, which was subjected to all sorts of discrimination and destruction, is now marching and progressing ahead tremendously in all sectors. Success in power sector. In the power sector, the Telangana state had achieved marvelous success to the surprise of the entire nation. In the erstwhile United AP rule, the people of Telangana suffered a lot due to the power cuts and crop holidays. The industrial production too suffered badly due to power holidays. That was why people desired for a separate state so that they could overcome the situation. The then rulers threatened that the state would plunge into utter darkness, proving all their forecasts as false. My government transformed the state into an illuminating one. The very complicated power crisis in the state was overcome successfully by the state government within a very short span of time. The Telangana state had rewritten a new history as the only state which is providing 24-hour free supply to the farm sector and uninterrupted power to all the sectors. This is the first of the kind in the state. The installed power capacity at the time of formation of the state was only 7,778 megawatts, whereas it is 16,245 megawatts now. The then transmission capacity was 13,900 megawatt amperes, whereas now it is reached to 37,000 MVA. Then per capita power consumption was 1,110 units, whereas it is increased now to 2,071 units. This was announced by the Central Electricity Authority, which is an indication of great success that the Telangana state achieved in power sector. Telangana's per capita power consumption is higher than that of the nation's average of 1,208 units. The solar power was only 71 megawatts then, and now it is 4,840 megawatts. Then the maximum peak demand of United AP was 13,162 megawatts, while it is 13,468 megawatts recently. Government of India complimented my government's success in power front for supplying uninterrupted quality power without any power cuts, in spite of marked increase in the number of power connections, per capita consumption and maximum peak demand. This is itself is a great success story for the government, which has been appreciated by the union government. In recognition of this success that the state government registered in power sector, Council of Energy, Environment and Water, CEW, announced awards to the electricity corporations in the state. It is an indication of our progressive outlook that Niti Aayog has announced that Telangana got third rank among the list of the best states which supply affordable clean energy without harming the environment and also with considerably less financial burden on people. This is it. Another indication of state's progressive outlook in managing energy resources. The works on Yadadri, Bhadradri power plants are being completed on fast track to make the state a power surplus state. In power sector, this is a great and delightful success story. In this modern era, electricity is a development index and a priority sector. The Central Electricity Authority announced that my government, by taking all necessary safeguards and working on a continuous basis, achieved successes in power sector. This sort of work has not taken place anywhere in the country. Mission Bhagiratha, permanent solution to drinking water problem. Mission Bhagiratha scheme completely put an end to the drinking water problem, and that the Telangana people suffered for decades over. This scheme has become a torchbearer for the entire country to follow and emulate. This is a matter for all of us should feel proud of. The Central Jal Shakti Mission has declared that Telangana state is the one and only state in the country which is providing safe and pure drinking water through pipes to all the households, schools, Anganwadi centers. This is a befitting recognition to the state government's efforts. Through Mission Bhagiratha scheme, safe drinking water is supplied to all remote villages, tribal tandas and Adivasi gudams. Prior to 2014, drinking water supply was provided, that too partially, to just 5,672 habitations. Now, protected drinking water is supplied to 24,543 habitations, to every household, every day through pipes and taps. On the whole, there are 57,26,804 household tap connections, 65 intake wells, 109 water treatment plants, 1,49,905 kilometers long pipelines, and 13,901 service crossings were constructed as part of this mega scheme. 87,412 connections were given to the Anganwadis, schools, right to Vedikas and Vaikundh Dhamams. Prior to 2014, there were only 17,769 overhead service reservoirs, and with new construction of 19,233 reservoirs, the number increased to 37,002.